Hi, in this tutorial we will continue solving the SQL queries that we started in the previous tutorial. Now, for this next query, if we compare with the previous one, the only difference is that now we changed the OR in the previous one for an AND. Why? Because we go back to the previous one. This is the most common way of answering this type of query. Like, for example, we have an OR, we say that that's correct because it says, okay, the B color can be red or can be green. Now, I have seen multiple times that if I change the OR for an AND, then the students basically change the OR for an AND, and that will be a mistake because the B color cannot be red and at the same time can be green. So there is a difference. Look at that. If we want to do the join, then we need to specify two reservations, and that's what we have here. The both V1 with R1 will be reservation number one, and then we join V2 with R2. That will be my second reservation. And then we do the joins. Again, sailors is not needed in the answer that is provided here in the textbook, but we will do that in our implementation. We'll change that. So here we got two reservations, and then we say for reservation number one, the color is red, and for reservation number two, the color was green. So now that's possible. So you need to compare this with the previous one in the case of the join. Or, for example, the one that is a nice change is here we got the reservation for red, here we got the reservation for green within the union. So something that could be done is doing the reservation for the changing the union for the intersection, and that will be a good answer. So now let's go and see my answer that we will implement in our Oracle account. So you see for the answer, the changes that I have is that I changed the union for intersect. I deleted the table sailors from here and here because it's not needed. We're not getting any information from table sailors. And the other thing that I did, if we go back to the PowerPoint, is that I also noticed that here they're using the same S and S, and that's something that I don't like because that should be different. I mean, in case that we got a problem with correlation. So in our implementation, look at that. Here I got the B2, R2, and then here is B and R. So just to make them different, I did that. So we copy, and then I'm gonna paste that in my Oracle account. And this is what I get as an answer, was I'm implementing that in the Oracle account using the JQBedo account. Now let's go to the next one. So now, in the next section, we're introducing where we have nested queries. So what it means is a query inside another query. So for example, here, finding the sailors who have reserved that boat. I mean, we could do that with a simple join. Here we can open sailors and then comma. We can also do reserves to the join between the two tables. And then add in the where the conditions with SID is the same as R. The R SID, and then the board identification is 103. However, here what it says, okay, select the name of sailors such that their identification is in the following set or in the following list. So in this list, we got the reservation IDs of those who reserve 103. So if your identification is in this list, provide the name. So for my next query, I think what I want is just to practice that it is not in there. So that's something that this is maybe easier to see it when we're using the nested queries. So for that, I copy and paste basically the same thing. And again, I did the changes of adding the JQBedo because that's where my table is located. And then I put the not in, and then I will see how that is implemented on my account. And this is what you should see as an answer once you implement it there. Okay, so here we got another example in which they use correlation solving the same query. So in this case, we're solving the same one, but now instead of using in, it says exist. Exist means that in this case, we select the name if this returns something that is non-empty. I mean, there is something here, there is a tuple, there is a role, there is an answer. So for example, there is a reservation, so we don't care. Here the status says just give me the answer or the reservation of the there is a reservation for the booth 103 that was reserved by this person. So if there is something, this is not empty, if this is not empty, then that's what we get with the access, and then we get it. So now if we want this to be empty, then we get this with the not access. Now there is something that they have in the book that is not okay in Oracle, that they say, and that's what I have in my next query, the unique. For the unique, they expect that maybe we change here for the unique, and that would make a lot of sense. That says, okay, this is a unique, that means this is not empty. And it returns only just one row, one tuple. So in that case, it will be okay to say that it has at most one reservation. However, this is not the way that it's going to be implemented. I will give you what could you can practice for that query. And I highlighted that with yellow because it's not actually answering what we want here. And we will revisit this in the next tutorial, because in the next tutorial we will use aggregate operators in which we can count the number of rows that we can get in an answer. So I'm just highlighting that, okay, to practice this. And look at that, I still have the exist here, and I'm putting the unique here because the unique can be used here, kind of like the distinct, but it's not actually answering the query that I have. I mean, there is something that I'm just following what they have on the PowerPoints, but I'm highlighting that says no, this is not okay. Just for you practice and see what did you get, and we will revisit that in the next tutorial when we actually want to count. I'm not doing that now because we're not in that specific section of SQL, but we will very soon. Okay, so there are other set comparison operators that will be very useful for queries. Like for example, here we can compare the rating with any of the list of ratings that are in this list. So for example, here we got, let's suppose that the rating for this person is, I don't know, 5, and then here we got 7, 11, and then one is 3. So this is greater, the rating of this person is greater than one with the 3. So then they should be selected. And then that any can also be changed for all. That means the rating is to be greater than any order that is listed in there. So I think this is my next query that I have here. That's my query number 7, in which I have this way of being implemented. And then again, I want you to check that in your Oracle account. And that's what I will do now. So then you should get an answer that looks like that. And finally, for this section, there is another way that they are doing the one who has the reservation, the red and the green, in which they are using the in here, where it says, okay, here this the sailor has already a reservation for a red boat, and the identification of that sailor is also in this list, which is the reservation for a green. So that will be another way of solving queries. So what we see now is that queries can also have multiple answers, which shouldn't be a surprise. Okay, so these were all answers that you're supposed to post. Remember that this is highlighted because this is not what we want, but we're just practicing, and we will get the right answer on the next tutorial. Thank you.